Hi, my name is Ethan Bannister. I'm the acoustic systems engineer for Mackie. Today we're going to talk a bit about the Advanced Impulse DSP. With the technology developed and contained within Advanced Impulse DSP, we've been able to produce some of the best sounding loudspeakers in our company's history. Advanced Impulse DSP, present in Mackie products, is an application of FIR filtering that is unique and shaped by 30 years of industry experience. So when you're designing a loudspeaker, the first step of the process is component selection. The components you choose have inherent performance anomalies in their usable passbands. So the way to go around this, the way to correct for these anomalies traditionally is using IIR filters, which is basically parametric EQ in a way to smooth out the response. You can fill in the valleys and, you know, pull down the peaks, and your response gets less notchy. The issue with using parametric EQ for this is that you're not just affecting the magnitude response of the component itself, you're affecting the phase response as well. So as it pertains to loudspeakers and in the world of acoustics, phase can essentially be distilled down to the position of a cone relative to its resting place. During replication of sound, the cone will move out, move back, and come back to a starting place, kind of like a sinusoid wave. And phase tells us where in that path of travel it is. This is relevant and important because when you have two different transducers replicating the exact same frequency, like around a crossover point, you want them to be moving in harmony with each other. If one is moving forward while the other one's moving back and they cross paths, the produced wavefront cancels itself and your output is dramatically reduced. Poor phase response causes a host of issues depending on venue size and speaker configuration and layout. So you want to try and avoid using an exhaustive amount of parametric EQ, you know, IIR filters. So in order to avoid mangling the phase response, especially of your HF component, you can use a different kind of filter instead. Instead of an IIR filter, we're using an FIR filter. And the difference there is an FIR filter is able to independently correct for magnitude response and phase response. So you can shape the frequency response of your HF and, you know, mid frequencies. With an FIR filter, you're, especially in the HF, you're able to achieve a level of granular control over your magnitude response, which would typically require very aggressive IIR filters to take care of. And you're able to achieve this level of, you know, smoothness, flattening, without having a phase response that is peaky and winding all over the place. You don't perceive things to be overly weighted one direction or another. For example, a snap or a hi-hat doesn't sound, irregular, doesn't sound fake or overly processed. You're able to replicate audio in that spectrum pretty reliably without too much color. Is basically like taking a grater for a road and just smoothing all of that out, because you're now turning your speaker more into a tool of reproduction and not into like a flavor, right? You're not spicing your food, you're just cooking it. So in order to drive the algorithm that runs our Advanced Impulse DSP, we rely on data taken from loudspeaker measurements. This data is highly important because the resolution of the data is directly proportionate to the level of correction you're able to achieve. If you only have rough collected data, not very accurate, you are not correcting for the right anomalies that come out of a speaker. So Mackie Acoustics has access to some of the top of the line bleeding edge audio equipment for measurement and data collection. So when we talk about data collection, we're talking about a complex polar measurement system that operates a microphone moving around on three separate axes, centric around a loudspeaker in the very middle. The data generated from this can be extrapolated into a full
3D balloon that can tell you response and output at any point in space from that speaker.
This gives us the ability to generate this enormous pool of data, and then we are able to pick and choose exactly what data sets we want from this to drive our algorithms. Without high resolution data, you may end up correcting for things you don't need to correct for, which can affect your overall response and end in a bias in the sound that you were trying to avoid in the first place with this correction. The experience with the company, within Mackie, has given us the ability to look at this giant mountain of data and extract the exact measurements we need to correct for the exact, or for the intended result that we want. So at the end of it, what makes Advanced Impulse DSP unique? What sets it apart? And the answer to that is the application of the filtering that we've chosen to do. With Advanced Impulse DSP, we are choosing to have consistent correction instead of centric correction just axially on the speaker. What that translates to for the user is that the correction is even across the intended coverage area of the speaker, instead of just having a single path right down the middle that sounds perfect at the expense of stuff off to the sides. Acoustic processing has come a long way since 1989. All right, so the real secret they don't want me to tell you guys, the actual sauce behind our Advanced Impulse DSP, is really buried in the way that we use these specific data sets.
Ethan, you playing this hand?